So how did this exhibition come about?
Well, I have a regular life drawing session on a Wednesday, and one of the artists, only 3 weeks ago I think, we'd been reading stories and we were talking about it and feeling quite useless and helpless and appalled, and he just casually mentioned that we could sell some pictures to make some money. And I just sort of, it just hit me that yes, of course we could do that. And I knew someone with a gallery, which is where we are now. I asked him, he said yes, so I thought, okay, maybe we can do something here. I asked about 20 artists, just literally reaching out to all the people that I know, people that I know make professional work and sell it and are already versed in that. We've got some people who are more amateurs and they don't sell their work, they don't frame it, they don't have exhibitions, but I know that they're good, and that was the main thing. Do I know they're good? Because they're from our group of friends, our social circle, they tend to be quite queer, quite intersectional, quite interesting, amazing people. So that was kind of the pool that we were drawing from. And everyone just was saying yes. Pretty much everybody said yes. And they had things framed, or sometimes, in some cases, they made things specifically for this show, and they brought them here, delivered them, posted them down from Scotland, from all over the place, from Spain. I was really touched, and then I was a bit nervous because I thought, well, now it's really happening, we really have to do this. And we just kept asking more artists as we went along, and more people kept saying yes. So that's how it began, just kind of feeling kind of helpless, and just that one thought, well, what can we do as artists? We can't institute, you know, social change, we can't get justice. We can't go over there and give these people a good talking to and just say stop treating your homosexuals this way, but we can raise a little bit of money for the organisations who are doing something to help.
So would you say the response from artists was quite immediate then, like everyone just jumped in and wanted to help?
Yeah, pretty much. No one really even had any questions. They understood the situation. I mean, I wrote a bit of a long email just explaining the situation. Most people already knew the situation. Surprisingly, quite a number of people haven't heard what's going on. It seems that this is a kind of considered a sort of gay interest story and is not yet on the international news agenda in a big way. And we're constantly questioning it, trying to get perspective on it anyway. It's, in terms of an atrocity, it's not as big as something like Syria. But on the other hand, it's not something that we can just ignore. When we first started, we had a few aims that we wanted to achieve, aside from raising money. One of them was get the Prime Minister to actually say something about this. And she did, about a week later. But it's not enough to just say something. You know, now we have to, at the very least, be welcoming refugees into this country and giving people asylum if they need it. I think this country could use more gays. I think we have the room.
So where is all the money that's been made going to?
So everything's going to the Russian LGBT network. If you look on their site, you can see a breakdown of all the things that they're doing for gay people in Chechnya. Chechnya is part of Europe, but it's owned by Russia or whatever. It's complicated. It's too complicated for me to follow. But Russia calls the shots there, and the Russian LGBT network does a lot there for people. It's an absolutely dreadful situation to be gay there, or to be a woman there, or, you know, basically to not be at the top of the patriarchy. I think is quite dreadful. And it's not perfect here either. I'm not slinging stones, but the Russian LGBT network do a lot. They have a phone line to start with to contact people. They're getting people visas to get the hell out of there. They find them spaces to protect them. I mean, some of these people, as soon as they get wind that the authorities are onto them, they just run home, grab a bag and leg it, and they have to ditch their phone and, you know, lose contact with everybody, because if they're caught, they'll be tortured for their connections to anyone else. So they just have to completely separate themselves from everything that they know, and the Russian LGBT network are there to help support them in that and help rehabilitate them and get them somewhere else.
Do you have any favourite art pieces that have been given here?
I'm looking at one right now. Yeah, there's a nice one over here. It's by James Davison, who's a really fantastic designer, an artist. His background is in makeup, and I think it kind of shows he has a very flamboyant style. And right next to him is Richard Kilroy's work with some lovely millennial pink. It's a very pink kind of wall. And next to that is Daniela Attard, who painted that especially for this show.
Wow.
And then next to you here is some stuff by Boltron, who's a lovely bear from Madrid, who does absolutely brilliant 3D digital work. And some of these are animated as well. He's got incredible skills.
Yeah.
So you find him on Instagram as Boltron.
And can you tell me a bit about the harness?
This one. This is by William Martin, who's done some really fantastic work for this show. He helped curate the entire thing and kind of chose where things should go. He's a real driving force behind actually the execution, physical execution of this show. And this is one of his ceramic pieces. Every single one of these links is handmade in clay. It's all been fired and they've all been carefully separated. And this is very durable. He's worn this out. In clubs, there's photos available. I'm sure I can share them with you. But yeah, we haven't yet had any bids on it. So if anyone watching this wants this piece, it's the second most expensive piece in the show. But you need it in your life. There's only one in the world. This is a total one-off. So yeah, grab it while you can. Someone's going to.
That actually leads me on to my last question. How can people get involved and help? I've heard there's a hashtag.
Yes, well there's two ways. So you can still bid on pieces in this show. If you want something here, you can either outbid someone or you can bid on something that has multiple versions available. There's also still books and zines available here that you can just buy. You don't have to bid on them. And artists, you know, if you're broke and money's the one thing you can't give, then you can auction one piece of your work with the hashtag One Piece for Chechnya, and which will help us keep track of who's doing this. We'll be able to find you online and we'll be able to show you off in our gallery and help, you know, boost attention for you and get your piece sold. And then you just donate directly. We're trusting people to do that. I think that people will. I generally find that you can trust people. Especially in a situation like this. So if you want to be involved in your artist, just auction off one piece of your work. It's really easy. On Instagram or something, you post the picture, you tell people what's going on, how much the first bid is, how much the reserve price is, and then just let people bid underneath in the comments. It's nice and easy. And then whoever bids the highest, you send it to them, get the money first, send it to them, and then send that money to the LGBT network.
Perfect.
The Russian LGBT network.
Perfect, thank you.